Hey everyone, it's Andrew here, here to do another movie review for you guys, and today I'll be reviewing the science fiction film. It's called Circle. Now I saw this one on Netflix just a few weeks ago, and I want to give this one a quick review because I haven't heard many people speak about this one, and I've never heard of it before I'm watching it. So the film is about these group of people who wake up in like this room, not entirely sure how they got it, about 50 people, all from all different walks of life, and they discover a part of a game on these like platforms, all in a circle, and if you leave the platform you die straight away. So they soon discover like only one of them can live, and they've got to somehow strategize how they can survive, how they can be the last one surviving, who should go over them, like stuff like race, like the black and the whites and like the Asians. You also got like a Mexican guy, they're all like fighting like over like, oh, if you're foreign you shouldn't be allowed, you should die straight away, stop using like the black card, because it was like the slavery days and all that other thing that people bring up, that what you're earning as well, so like lesser paid people, they should live more than the richer people because they had a less quality of life, and the rich people because they've had a good upbringing and stuff, had like a lot. They should deserve that because they already had a good life in that. And age, like straight away they decide to go say, hey, the oldest people, they should die straight away. But they also have like a kid and a pregnant woman. That the film was really predictable who will survive at the end, and I got straight away, like, if you see this kid and pregnant woman, you think those two are gonna survive. And they survived right to the end. And but there was a bit of a twist on that, like it was predictable but it was a twist, but they ruined it after the twist, so it didn't matter. Like, what the fuck, like if you notice the woman's pregnant, that gives it a bit of a clue. Like, then there's one guy who's, he said he's there from a previous one, which he kind of uses to get further and further in the process of the game. And he was pretty good, but it was really predictable who was going to survive. I did want this one guy, the Mexican guy, I did want him to survive because he's the only guy that couldn't speak English, like he couldn't communicate with everyone else. I thought he would probably survive, the most idiotic person winning, but children and stuff like that, it's just so predictable that they're going to survive. And the way they died as well is if they leave a platform, they just get dragged off and they go to the back. But if some of the characters you don't actually see that, you just look on someone's facial expressions. Like, I thought that was pretty bad how they could have done that much better. The whole idea of the film was pretty good, but how they played it out was pretty bad. So some of the characters were quite annoying, but I know that's supposed to be part of their character traits. But like, come on, I want you to die, and who you want to survive doesn't survive, and who you want to die survives, and like, well, survive until it's just like one person, but I'm not going to tell you who that one person is. But yeah, overall it's not a bad film, it's nothing fantastic. I say one major problem of this film was that You don't understand why they were there. They say it's aliens, but you don't actually see any aliens or any proof that this is from aliens that caused this. So I was a bit confused, like, why are they there? Because the whole entire film, just them in the room, and the last person gets out. The end of the film. Like, what the fuck? All this build up, going for everything, and you want to just, like, to know why they were there, that's all we need to know. If they showed you that, then they wouldn't go. Let's even an alien walking in halfway through, just check up on them, see what's happening. That would make it great, but nope. So it's been my quick review of Circle. I give this one a 6 out of 10. Pretty average, nothing fantastic, but not bad either. I still say worth checking out just because of the premise of the film, but overall, it's nothing you've got to see again. I don't think I'm going to be seeing this anytime soon. But thanks for watching, and goodbye. Cheers for watching.